Anyone who knows me at all knows how I feel about New York City, how much I love this town and how lucky I feel to be living here. You've all heard me refer to it as Florence during the Renaissance, or the only truly international experiment that works every single day. In fact, I love this town so much that I think it would be a really cool thing if there was something like a uniquely New York thing, like, I would say, a guitar man in Central Park who'd be in the same spot for an entire generation, just writing and singing songs about life and love and sharing music and laughs for, you know, a few thousand of his closest friends every weekend. What's amazing to me is that there actually is such a thing. And what really blows me away on a regular basis is that he's me. So when a bunch of friends and I started to put this concert together to celebrate the fact that 2016 marks 25 years of that guitar man from Central Park, we thought it would be a great idea if we asked a fellow New Yorker to introduce the night.
This is Jerry Seinfeld welcoming you to Central Park. I always think of that scene in Kramer versus Kramer when I walk through here, where he teaches his son to ride the bicycle.
But none of us know Jerry Seinfeld, and we probably couldn't get him to talk about me anyway. So I'll just start the night off by taking you all back to that very first day, a quarter century ago. I usually tell people that 26 years ago, I considered myself a failure as a human being in every way you could possibly be, coming out of a long chapter of active alcoholism, you know, the sex, drugs, and rock and roll years. But everything about my life began to change as 1991 came to an end. And in the spring of 1992, as the lights in the building began to come back on, I was struck with the idea that I might make a little extra lunch money by playing music in Central Park. Now that next week, I must have been very late for something I thought was very important, because as broke as I was, I found myself in a cab that was cutting through Central Park. And we stopped at a light in an area of the park called Hearn's Head. And I remember as I looked out the window waiting for the light to turn green, I saw a little spot where the walking path veered away from the main drive. And I thought to myself, you know, if I played a little music down there, I won't be in anyone's face, and thousands of people who want nothing to do with me could just keep walking. But if anybody heard the music and liked it, they could just come down this grassy little hill and hang out for a while. Now, at the time, I was working as a bartender and waiter in an Italian restaurant on 9th Avenue and living on the fifth floor of a five-floor walk-up in Hell's Kitchen with no furniture and a futon mat on the floor. Now, I was broke, but I spent about $200 of the $300 in my financial empire and bought a little Maxi Mouse speaker. And then I spent another $30 for one of those little old lady wire shopping carts. Now, don't ask me how, but I still had an old microphone duct taped to a mic stand. And the next Saturday, I was paralyzed with fear and I couldn't even get out the door. But then on Sunday, with every ounce of the little courage I had left or any self-esteem I had, I packed everything up, put it in the back of a cab, and I headed to the park. As I set up the equipment, I remember there were about four or five people sitting on this little hill, hanging out, reading the newspaper, just chatting with each other. I approached each of them and I asked if it would bother them if I played a few songs. Now, being New Yorkers, they all just kind of nodded and said, "Nah, it's cool." So I, you know, let the guitar and the speaker get comfortable in that spot for about a half hour. I wasn't writing any songs back then because I sincerely felt I had nothing of any importance to say to the world. But when I finally mustered up the courage to start that day, the very first song I sang was James Taylor's Sweet Baby James. It just felt right. In fact, from that moment on, that day, everything felt right. And in about an hour or so, I looked out and there might have been 300 or 400 of us just singing together, laughing together, just hanging out together in the middle of the greatest city in the world. Still, I had absolutely no way of knowing when I sang that first song where this musical journey was going to take me for the next 25 years.
got some dreams I'd love to chase. I got my head where it belongs. I got my heart in a real good place. Singing other people's songs. New Yorkers feed the birds. Pick it till my fingers ache. Singing other people's words. But it seemed the time had come for letting go and getting real. Getting right down to it and let you know the way I feel. 'Cause we've been singing in the sun, smiling all the time until I had to write this one for the people on the hill.
Hey, hey!
Hey!
That was horrible. Can I get the house lights up, AJ, a little bit? How many people, like, have no idea what that was about? That video. How many people have been to the hill in Central Park? All right, so that's what that was. My only thing at Central Park, see, I just have to be the guy with the guitar. So my whole thing is, if you know any of this stuff, you sing it with me. All right, now that was just two words. So you sing it back and forth. It's a back and forth kind of thing. We'll try it again, right? Oh, and if anybody in your life ever told you that you don't sing, how many people have been told they don't sing very well? Okay. Like in a park, and tonight, if anybody in your life, your mother, a teacher, a friend, a husband, a wife, if anybody ever told you you don't sing very well, sing louder. All right? It's just us. All right, so let's try it here.
From the start, but I can still remember. when singing helps me heal my heart. You may have saved a life back then, and now I've cut a place in this world writing songs on one guitar. And when you're singing with me, it makes me feel I've done all right so far.
So you're gonna do it? I really mean it. Embarrass yourself, right? As loud as you possibly can.
Speakers, powered speakers on stands, right? This is it. Isn't this cool? It doesn't work anymore.